So today's subject matter is who is the mastermind behind this universe? A lot of people ask this question, does God exist or not? If at all they believe God does exist, they have different answers. Correct? Somebody will call somebody as God, somebody will call somebody else as God. The purpose of this session is to bring clarity on the subject. First of all, does God exist or not? And second, not in this session, next session we'll talk about who is that one God who exists and controls everything. Okay. Before that, we said that this session or this course of self-discovery is based on the learnings of Bhagavad Gita, right? It's a very important verse from 9th chapter. It says, Raj Vidya Raj Guhyam Pavitram Idam Uttamam Prataksha Avagamam Dharmayam Su Sukham Kartum Avyayam. And they're very important words in this verse. Maybe you can also see yourself. This knowledge is, the first important word is king of education, which means there is no knowledge superior to wisdom of Bhagavad Gita. No wonder this Bhagavad Gita is published in more than 80 languages across the world. People across countries are reading this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. And second important word in this translation you can see is, it is the most secret of all secrets. Bhagavad Gita is available in everybody's house, but people are not aware what is the content of Bhagavad Gita. What is the essence of, even though they know all the 700 verses of Bhagavad Gita, they do not understand what is the essence of Bhagavad Gita. And the third is, it is the purest knowledge. And fourth important aspect of this knowledge is direct perception of the self by realization. What does it mean? We are talking about a very important subject of self-realization. It is not only theoretical knowledge, but it is also one experiencing his own identity. Correct? Bhagavad Gita claims that one can experience one's identity only with this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Because this subject matter is not explained anywhere else, only in Bhagavad Gita. Ye jo hum padh rahe hain, Atma Sakshatkar ka Vigyan, ye keval Bhagavad Gita ke andar upasthit hai aur kahin iski charcha nahi ki gayi hai. And then it is the perfection of religion, everlasting, and then finally it is joyfully performed. The subject matter we discussed in the previous session, search for happiness. So when one reads Bhagavad Gita, his search for happiness ends. His search for happiness ends, right? Then no more knowledge, no more understanding is required to search for happiness, right? The search will end in the pages of Bhagavad Gita. We discussed in the previous session that this knowledge is universal. Universal means it is equally applicable for everyone across all the countries, not only for a specific section of society. Everyone, irrespective of what is his external body, it does not matter. It is universal. Second, it is a universal science. Like 2 plus 2 is 4. It is 4 in India, it is 4 in America. Similarly, Bhagavad Gita is applicable here. It is equally applicable in America. It is equally applicable in Russia. It is equally applicable in Pakistan or Bangladesh. Right? It is universally applicable. And it is not only a theoretical understanding, it is a So knowledge can be applied in our day-to-day life. Very practical. And then we discussed that the four habits which are common in animals and human beings. Correct? Eating, sleeping, meeting, and defending. Ahar, Nidra, Bhay, Maithunamcha. There are four common biological instincts between human beings and animals. The question is, then what is the difference between animals and human beings? What makes human beings superior to animals? Very, very important question. Everybody is busy arranging for food, whether it is animal or human being. Everybody is busy arranging for shelter. It is animal or human being. Everybody is busy defending against uncertainties, whether animal or human beings. Everybody is busy recreating in procreation, producing children, having a family life, right? Everybody is busy doing these four things. Then what makes human beings different from Mahabharata? This verse is explained, which we discussed in the previous session. Ahar, Nidra, Bhay, Maitunamcha, Samanyam, Etat, Pashubhi, Narana, Dharmo, Hitesham, Adhiko, Vishesho, Dharme, Nahina, Pashubhi, Samana. So what makes human beings superior? It is Dharma. Animals cannot understand Bhagavad Gita. Animals cannot sit together like this and talk about self-realization. आपने देखा पशुओं की सभा जहां पर बैठ के वो चर्चा कर रहे हैं आत्म साक्षात्कार का विज्ञान क्या होता है? Have you ever seen? Animals are seen busy only in eating, sleeping, mating and defending. Nothing else. Yes, only human beings can sit together and contemplate and talk about this important subject. Dharma. And what is dharma, we'll discuss a little later. Right? As of now, what differentiates human beings and animals is athato brahma jigyasa, curiosity to understand who is managing this universe. Why do I suffer? Why do I become old? Why do I get so many diseases? Why do I die? Animals cannot ask this question. Can they? Can they ask? Bhaskar Prabhu? Can they ask? No. Only human can ask. If you get sick, you know where to go. You go to the doctor and take some medicine. Does dog know this? Because they have higher level of intelligence. Like getting cancer or getting heart attack is an abnormal condition of life, correct? It is abnormal condition. Asadharan sthiti hai. To become normal, you visit whom? Doctor. Similarly, according to our Vedic scripture, becoming old is abnormal. Becoming sick is abnormal. Dying is abnormal, which means there is some condition which is contrary to these conditions. There's some normal condition which exists. A human being is a human being when he inquires, what is that condition? The basic inquiry, athato brahma jigvasa, why am I suffering? Who is he who created this mysterious world and why? Who am I? What is this material nature and purpose? And what is the relationship between amongst three? Bhagavad Gita talks about five subject matters. पांच विषयों की चर्चा है भगवद गीता के अंदर. पहला ईश्वर, दूसरा जीव, तीसरा प्रकृति, चौथा कर्म और पांचवा काल यानी कि समय. इन पांच को छोड़कर और कुछ नहीं. इफ यू थिंक लॉजिकली इंटेलिजेंटली, there is no subject matter other than these five subject matters. The first one is Ishwar. Ishwar means controller. who controls every activity of this universe. Second is Jiva, all of us, who are controlled, not controller. And the third is Prakriti. What is the role of Prakriti? We'll understand in the next session. And fourth is Karma. Everybody is doing some or the other work. He is involved in some activity. So what does he get in return? Which is called law of karma. That is explained in Bhagavad Gita. And fifth one is Kala. Kala means Samay, time, which makes everything temporary. You keep one apple here. After 2 days, this apple is rotten. So what made that apple rotten? Time. Correct? 10 years back, I was very much younger than what I look now. What made my hair gray? Time. Kal. You buy a new house, it looks brand new. After 2 years, it becomes old. You buy a new car, after 2 years, it becomes old. So what makes everything old? It is time. Samay. Kal. So these five subject matters are discussed in Bhagavad Gita. So human beings inquire, why everything is getting old? What made this apple rot? Like Newton inquired, why apple falling down? A human being makes also inquiry, why apple is getting rot? Then he'll understand, oh, it is time. But that answer he will get only when he makes inquiry. जब वो जिज्ञासा उत्पन्न करता है तभी उसको इस प्रश्न का उत्तर मिलता है. The very purpose of human life is to make such inquiries. Okay? The very purpose of human life is to make such inquiries. If one is not making such inquiries, he is as good as animals. Very good. Dharmo rakshati rakshita. We said it is dharma which differentiates between human beings and animals. Shastra, scriptures say, if you protect dharma, dharma will protect you. If you destroy dharma, dharma will destroy. Over a period of time, we have been perpetually destroying dharma. And that is the reason we have a situation like Kali Yuga now. So many problems. These problems are not given by somebody else. It is self-created. We have created this problem. Not somebody else sitting there. Okay. I wanted to show one video. But it's okay. We'll go ahead. So this is the life expectancy falling down in the last four yugas. I mentioned briefly in the previous session. In Satyuga, it was 1 lakh years. In Treta Yuga, it was 10,000 years. In Dwapar Yuga, 1,000 years. And Kali Yuga, how much is the maximum age? 100 years. In Satyuga, height used to be around 32 feet. And now in Kali Yuga, 5 feet, 5.5 feet. So this decline has happened. Why? Because we have been destroying dharma. Destroying what? Dharma. It's a natural consequence of destruction of spiritual principles. Nothing else. There is no other reason. There is a strong correlation. Yeah. And then we discussed about what are the real problems of life. We discussed about janma, mrityu, jara, vyadi, dukkha, dosha, anudarshanam. Death, old age, disease, and birth. These four are the real problems of life. All the problems take birth along with birth. Repeat after me. All the problems take birth along with our birth. isn't it? And other than these four problems we discussed, there are three more problems called Adhyatmika, Adhibhautika, and Adhidevika. Problems given by our body and mind, problems given by other living entities, and problems given by nature, demigods, like tsunami, akal, flood. Who gives these problems? Nature. Why? Because we violate principles, laws of nature. So we are punished. Materially, and all the big problems are there in that country, right? Divorce rate is increasing, teen suicide rate is increasing, recorded violent crime is increasing, prison population increasing, illegitimate children, illicit relationship increasing, and depression is increasing. Which country? America. Most advanced materially. Yeah. So you see, destruction and material advancement go together. Material advancement and goes together. Very strong correlation. So any amount of material progress cannot eliminate these sufferings. So we have to find something else. And then we discuss that, why are we suffering? Because we are living in a very unnatural condition. Like fish, when taken out of water, is an unnatural condition. Correct? To fish, you give anything materially, fish will never be happy. Will it be happy? You give ornaments to fish, you give, five-course buffet to fish, will not be happy. Give nice clothing to fish, not be happy. Fish will be happy only when it goes inside water. Machli, yeah? Jal ki rani hai. Yeah, what is that? Jeevan uska pani hai. So like machli ke liye jeevan jal hai, वैसे हमारे लिए भी एक ऐसी नेचुरल कंडीशन है इन विच वी कैन बी इटर्नली हैप्पी. सो द पर्पस ऑफ सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन इज टू फाइंड आउट टू डिस्कवर दैट नेचुरल कंडीशन. दिस वी डिस्कस्ड. एनिमल्स कैन इंक्वायर ओनली अबाउट ईटिंग, स्लीपिंग, मेटिंग एंड फियरिंग, बट ह्यूमन बींग्स कैन इंक्वायर अबाउट लाइफ, डेथ एंड बियॉन्ड. Animals do not have the ability to ask these questions. Okay, let's discuss. So finally, we ended here in the previous session that who has made this material world and why? Anything you manufacture washing machine, it has some purpose, correct? You manufacture refrigerator, it has some purpose. You construct a house, it has some purpose. You made laptop, it has some purpose. Similarly, this universe also has certain purpose. So today we'll see this important question. Is there someone behind this universe or not? Or everything is happening automatically? सब कुछ अपने आप हो रहा है या इसके पीछे कोई किसी का हाथ? Does God exist? So let me ask all of you a simple poll. Only one question to answer. Let me launch it. You all can see. How many of you believe God does exist? The first answer is, yes, I firmly believe. Second answer is, no, there is no one called as God. And third is, not sure. Okay. I'm getting a lot of answers as yes. Okay, yes, very good. Most of you believe God does exist. Okay, let's go ahead. So we'll try to find out three ways whether this personality called as God exists or not. The first one is simply by observations. Common sense. Simply by common sense. Second, we'll see what is the view of great scientists on this subject. And the third most important is, how do we access this truth? How do we find out who is God? Whether he exists or not, and finally, who is this personality? Okay, this answer we'll find out in the next session. The first two we'll try to answer today, which is through observations and through views of great scientists. Okay, let's look at through observations. आपको शायद नजर नहीं आ रहा होगा ना कुछ. So one simple exercise for all of you. Look at the world around you. Analyze and try to see the hand of some supreme power. Write down some observations. अपने आसपास देखिए क्या हो रहा है. See, do you see a hand of somebody else in whatever is happening in this material world? Write down a few observations. Yeah, maybe you can write in your chat box. Let me give example. Sun is rising every day and setting every day. Who is making this happen? Like this, few examples. Okay, life. What else? Air, oxygen to breathe, sun and moon, wind, rain. Yes, plants. Very good. What else? Sky. Yes. Breathing, flower bloom. Very nice. Fire. Okay, thank you very much. So let's see some examples like this. Some of you mentioned sun. Sun rises every day, sets every day. But we never think about who is controlling this sun. Have you ever bothered about this? Kaun kar raha hai? Kaun suraj ko ugata hai? Kaun usko chupata hai? We never ask this question. We see rains coming every season. We never ask this question. Who is responsible for rains? Right? We see wonderful flowers blooming around us. Who is making them bloom? We see so many grains, spices, pulses. Who is bringing it for us? You know, annad, bhavati, bhutani, Gita says, we cannot survive without grains. Who is providing grains to us? Okay. So many vegetables, fruits, diamonds, gold, silver, so many varieties of people, human beings, animals, insects, birds, plants. Right? So many planets in the sky hanging, not falling down. Ek sev tootta hai, vriksh se tura niche gir jata hai. Lekin itne bhari bhari grah hawa mein latak rahe hain. Who is holding them? Isn't it? Why they don't fall? Did we ever ask this question? Why sun is not falling down? Why moon is not falling down? Why the stars do not fall down? They are very heavy. So we should ask ourselves, how is sun rising every morning? How are flowers blossoming? How are seasons changing? How are vegetables, fruits getting life juices? Who puts gold, silver, diamonds in the womb of earth? And finally, how are these planets floating in the air? Isn't it a matter of inquiry? Hamare ghar mein toh leakage hota bhi inquire kaise ho gaya? Isn't it? So much of leakage happening from the sky, we never ask this question. Who is sending these rains? Isn't it? If you analyze, you'll, you know, not visibly, but through the pages of scriptures, you'll find all these planets are being held in somebody's hand. That's why they don't fall. There is some hand which is responsible for sun setting and rising every day. Right? There's somebody responsible for putting life juices into fruits and vegetables. Somebody making, you know, crops like grains, pulses, available for us. Nectar in the flowers, yes. Let's take one example. You know, this is, you know, example of two houses. One is in very dilapidated situation, very bad situation, and second is very organized. Okay. What difference you see in two houses? Can you please analyze? What is the difference? The difference is one house is completely dead, isn't it? One looks very alive, in order. Everything is placed in its right place. Alive, organized. It also actually means there's somebody living in this house who's making this happen. There's some organizer in this house which is making this house lively. Yes or no? And this house, there's no one. That's why it's dead. Right? Now, this universe looks dead or alive. In this universe, we see plants, fruits, diamonds, vegetables, sun, rain. Does this universe seem like a dilapidated house, or it looks like a very orderly, harmonized house in which somebody is living, somebody is controlling it? What's your view? Yes. So like this house was in order because somebody is making it happen, this universe is in order, harmonized, because somebody is making it happen. Somebody is putting some order in this. If you find out definition from dictionary, definition of universe, it says the word or universe regarded as an orderly, harmonious system. Orderly, harmonious system. Seasons come at specific time. Sun rises at specific time. Sun sets at specific time. Correct? There's some order. आप 6 महीने पहले बता सकते हैं कि इस तिथि को कितने बजे सूर्य उदय होने वाला है. Okay? Correct? Why? There is some order. आपको पता है कौन से सीजन के बाद कौन सा सीजन आता है? It may be some order. Isn't it? But who is making this universe harmonious? Anyone of you? None of us. Correct? None of us. There's somebody who is putting an order into everything in this universe. Correct? You see, children, when they see puppets, you know, they wonder how these puppets are dancing. They ask their mother, how are they dancing? Mother will tell them, Baba, there's somebody on the top controlling these puppets. The puppets do not move by themselves. Somebody is making them move. Right? There's some controller. Isn't it? So there's some supreme power which does exist. There's some mastermind which is planning, organizing, putting these things into perfect order. That sun will rise at specific time, sun will set at specific time, rains will come at specific time. Isn't it? Simply through observation, we can find out there's some superpower which is making all these things happen. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now the question is that supreme power a subject matter of individual perception? Sometimes people ask people, does God exist? They'll say, in my opinion. You know? Correct? In my opinion, I assume, if you ask me, as far as I can tell, to my mind, they give their own perception. You ask 10 different people, they'll give you 10 different answers. So is this subject matter of perception? What do you think, audience? Is it a subject matter of individual perception that who is God? It is universal. So we cannot ask everyone and go by what their opinion is. Okay. So it is not a matter of your opinion or my opinion. This is universal truth. And we must find out from the right sources what is that universal truth. We should not speculate. We should not speculate. In my view, your view, my view has no meaning on this subject. Right? We have to take some universal view, which is the subject matter of how do we get access to this truth. That we'll discuss later. Okay. Like, you know, a father was sitting in meditation and chanting, hey ma, hey ma, hey ma. Right? Maybe he's meditating on, you know, Mother Durga during Navratri. Hey ma, hey ma. And his son is also meditating. And he's also chanting, hey ma, hey ma, hey ma. But he is chanting on Hema Malini. And this father is chanting on Mother Durga. But both are saying, hey ma, hey ma, hey ma. Isn't it? So everybody says God, 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 but the perception is completely different. For someone, God is some entity. For another person, God is some different entity altogether. Yeah. So this subject matter is not a subject matter of individual perception. Even some people, I can show you some picture. Some people treat Sachin Tendulkar as God. Isn't it? Cricket is religion, Tendulkar is my God. No, no, we are not talking about that God, which is based on one's individual perceptions. Okay. So we'll try to define God very objectively. Very objectively. Scientifically. So that there is no scope for any speculation. Yeah. You can see many wonderful paintings, very, you know, by well-renowned painters. Leonardo da Vinci, Mona Lisa. Yeah, like this, you have picture of mountains, you have picture of waterfall, you have picture of a bunch of flowers. When you see this kind of art, it implies there is some artist. Yes? There is some artist. Yes or no? Can this painting come by itself? Can it appear automatically? No, there is an artist behind this picture. But what about these original pictures? Original girl, original mountain, original waterfall, original flowers. There must be some artist behind these wonderful creations. Isn't it? if that painter Leonardo da Vinci is so famous, who has just drawn a picture on a piece of paper, how much famous this person should be who has actually created these creations? A human body, lush green beautiful mountains, wonderful waterfalls, fragrant roses. Does it not imply there's some artist behind this? Yes or no? Yeah, some wonderful mastermind behind this wonderful art. If you take, you know, example of a paper flower and a real flower, to make a paper flower, you know, children make it during the art classes, you need paper, you need color, you need brush, you need stick, and finally an artist to use all these, you know, items and make a paper flower out of it. What about real flower, which has fragrance, very gentle, you know, petals, very soft petals? Does it not require any artist? Question, who is the artist behind original flower? So, any artistry requires an artist. It cannot happen automatically. It cannot happen automatically. Okay. Now let's see some video. Okay. Please watch it. A couple of videos I'll show you. Are you able to hear?
In the world, each hive is comprised of thousands of bees working together in order to build and sustain a colony. Within the colony, each bee has a specific role to play, a job, if you will. These are jobs like foraging for food, tending to young larvae, and building a honeycomb. But with a brain about the size of a sesame seed, it begs the question, how do bees know what specific job they need to do in order to keep balance in the hive? The answer is written into the genetic makeup of each bee. And it starts with the queen bee, who has the unique ability to designate the sex of her children, which plays a pivotal role in their future. If the queen wants to lay a female egg, she will fertilize the egg by releasing spermatozoa that is stored in the spermatheca, which sits behind her ovaries. The spermatheca is filled during her first week of life, when she mates with up to 20 drones, or male bees. If the queen wants to lay a male egg, she will not release any spermatozoa as the egg leaves the ovaries. And drones have a singular job. That job is to mate with queens from other colonies to propagate the species. When they're not trying to mate, they eat leisurely from the honey reserves and wait for a queen to go on her nuptial flight. Female bees, or worker bees, do literally everything else. They keep the cells clean, care for the larvae, build cells, tend to the queen, store honey, forage, pollinate, guard the nest, and even feed male bees honey if they're begging for it. Each bee knows what to do because their hormones activate the part of their genetic makeup that tells them what jobs they have to tackle and when they have to tackle them. They go through four phases of jobs before dying. In phase one, bees go to work immediately after they emerge from metamorphosis, about 3 weeks after they're born. They begin cleaning the cells from which they emerged. After about 3 days, their hormones shift them into nurse bee mode. In this job, they feed the young brood that succeeds them. This lasts for about a week. Then phase three kicks in, and the workers become general handymen, moving farther away from the center of the hive and doing things like building honeycomb, storing food, and guarding the nest entrances. This lasts about a week. The final phase is the most dangerous. It's the foraging phase, where workers leave the nest to find pollen to bring home and feed the colony. This phase starts around day 41 and lasts until about day 50. After a short life of constant work, most workers will leave the nest as death approaches. The corpses of those that die inside the hive are carried out by undertaker bees. It's a thankless life for the worker bee, but this collaboration and process has made them one of the most successful superorganisms in nature.
Yeah. So there must be someone behind such wonderful organization capabilities, given to whom? These bees. You see these bees? So, kya banate hain? Who convert nectar of flower into honey. So much of organization behind this. Just look at another video. Okay. Right. So, beautiful organization means an organization. You see, the ability is given to bees, the ability is given to spider, and to make the most toughest natural fiber on this earth, tougher than the steel. This ability given, you know, we need very qualified architect to build this kind of cobwebs which a small spider can, you know, create. There must be someone who is, you know, awarding such abilities, such capabilities to these tiny, tiny, you know, creatures, isn't it? There must be some organizer behind this kind of wonderful organization. Like this, we see, you know, sleek cars, which are, you know, there must be some manufacturer. We see wonderful, desktop, laptops. There must be someone who has manufactured them. We see nice watches. There must be somebody who has designed them. We see skyscrapers. Somebody must have built them. So nothing happens without once somebody's intervention. That's a larger point trying to make here. Wonderful sculpture, somebody must have carved it, right? The question is, shouldn't this universe have a super intelligent creator too? Isn't it? Even a small flower requires an artist design. Yeah, a laptop requires some designer, some manufacturer. Why not this universe, this wonderful universe? Yes or no? What's your take on this? While most of you said, you know, you all believe in God. But through observations, we can very easily, through common sense, we can say there's so much of order and, you know, harmony in this material world, in this universe. There must be someone behind this. Yes, for sure. I can get your C answers. Yeah. Definitely there's someone. The question is to find out who is that someone. Okay. So creation implies there is some creator behind this wonderful creation. Right? Now, everything we see has been designed, created by a creator, but it also has some purpose. We don't manufacture wristwatch without any purpose. We don't manufacture mobile phone without any purpose. Why will somebody manufacture the universe without any purpose? Isn't it? You have made this rotary club for a certain purpose, right? So why not this universe, this grand universe with some purpose? But no one knows this. The problem is no one knows what is the purpose of this material world. They all think it is a place just to eat, sleep, defend, and mate. Just enjoy materially. That is not the purpose of this material world. That is what you're going to discover over the next few sessions. Look at this tiny seed, sequoia seed, just 1.5 centimeter long. You know what comes out of this seed? This long, 300 meters long tree. Out of this 1.5. So how someone is able to hide 300 meter long tree in a 1.5 inch seed? What a wonderful design. Yes or no? But we never think about it. We take it for granted. We see so many trees around us. We never think, how come from a small seed such a big tree has come out? This tree height is as high as Statue of Liberty, around 300 feet high. Just imagine the level of intelligence that superpower has, who is designing such wonderful things. Next, the human brain can store more information than all the libraries in the world. We, you know, take pride of our 2 GB, 5 GB, 10 GB, 15 GB, 20 GB. This brain which we carry, it has a capacity to store information equivalent to all the libraries in the whole of universe. हमारा जो ब्रेन है उसका इतना कैपेसिटी है जितनी भी पूरे विश्व में लाइब्रेरीज हैं वो सारा इंफॉर्मेशन उसमें स्टोर कर सकते हैं एक व्यक्ति के ब्रेन में. जस्ट इमेजिन व्हाट कैपेसिटी इट विल हैव. यू कांट इवन पुट अ नंबर. व्हेन वी सेंड अ सैटेलाइट इन द स्काई, व्हेन साइंटिस्ट सेंड अ सैटेलाइट इन द स्काई, they need to have 24 hours monitoring of those satellites through a specific control room. Correct? You have so many parameters to control: orientation, spin, velocity, heat dissipation, cosmic radiation, so many things to be controlled, to be monitored for one satellite which you have sent in the sky. Correct? What about Earth? Who is controlling Earth, which has, you can see the size, weight of the Earth, 6 × 10⁻²⁰ metric tons. Who is controlling movement of the Earth? One simple tiny satellite requires so much of control. What about the control required to control the movement of this Earth, which is so heavy? 6 × 10⁻²⁰ metric tons. Yeah. And this is moving around the sun at a speed of almost 1 lakh kilometers per hour. This Earth is moving around the sun at a speed of 1 lakh kilometers per hour. हमारा कोई ऐसा यंत्र है, कोई ऐसी ट्रेन है, ऐसा कोई फ्लाइट है which can move at this speed? Who is controlling? Control means there is some controller behind all of these planets. They're not hanging in the air. They're not rotating in specific orbit without any specific control. Okay. You know, what is the size of sun? 1.3 million Earths, 13 lakh prithviyan ek suraj ke andar sama sakti hain. Size of sun. 1.3 million Earths can be accommodated in one sun. Sun is 99.8% of total mass of the entire solar system. So heavy. Some wonderful, you know, statistics regarding sun. In 1 second, the sun produces enough energy to meet the current needs of the entire Earth for 5 lakh years. Ek second mein jitni energy aati hai, nikalti hai suraj se, 5 lakh varsh tak is puri prithvi ki jitni bhi energy requirement hai usko dene mein saksham hai. एक सन, वन सूर्य देव सफिशिएंट. सो वी हैव सो मेनी लॉज इन आवर कंट्री, ट्रैफिक लॉज. सिमिलरली देयर आर सो मेनी लॉज क्रिएटेड बाय दिस कंट्रोलर व्हिच वी स्टडी इन फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री, थर्मोडायनेमिक्स एंड मेनी अदर सब्जेक्ट्स. या so laws implies lawmaker, control implies controller, creation implies creator, design implies designer. Yeah. Now you see this. What is happening here? Some traffic light is not working and you see so much of mess. Correct? One traffic light is not working for 5 minutes and this is the situation which can arise. What if law of gravity fails for a few seconds? What will happen? Can you imagine? Law of gravity fails for a few seconds. What will happen? The universe will collapse immediately. But has it ever happened? Never. What a perfect law. What a perfect execution of the law. What if Earth moves an inch closer to the sun? This Earth moves just 1 inch closer to the sun. What will happen? It will be burnt immediately. So with such perfection, these laws are working. Means there is some lawmaker who is making these laws and executing these laws with perfection. Correct? Now you see here, somebody is very beautiful, somebody is ugly, somebody is handsome, somebody is whatever, like a beggar, somebody is doctor, somebody is a labor class. Who decides this? Who will become what? Who decides who will take birth in the family of Tatas or who will take birth in the family of somebody in Dharavi in Bombay? In some, you know. Who decides this? This is a law of karma. Decided by some control, some supreme controller. Which we have not been ever bothered to think about it. Do we have a choice? When do we get birth? When do we take? Which date we'll get birth? Do we have a choice to choose our parents, brothers, sisters? Which skin color? How much height? Then who decides? There's someone who's deciding this. Is it based on our karmas? Okay. Now, quickly we'll see some view from great scientists like Einstein, Newton, and Ramanujacharya. Okay. Einstein said, there is a perfect brain behind all the natural physical laws. So it's a view from a well-known, renowned, you know, scientist who is also believing that such physical laws cannot happen without intervention of some supreme controller, a big brain, very intelligent brain, right? Similarly, similar view from Newton. He's saying, I'll just read quickly. This most beautiful system of sun, planets, and comets could only proceed from the counsel and dominion of an intelligent and powerful being. This being governs all things, not as the soul of the world, but as the Lord of overall. And on account of his dominion, he is to be called as Lord God, universal ruler. So even great scientists are, you know, bewildered to see this kind of perfection in, you know, these laws. And they also believe that somebody is there who is making things happen. They're not happening automatically. While there's, you know, one theory, a similar view from, you know, Srinivas Ramanujam. Okay. So is it some big brain or big bang? There's some theory, scientific theory, which also claims this entire universe happened because of big bang, right? Which is being proved wrong now in many of the universities, and he will not talk about it. We are trying to establish here there is some intelligent person behind everything we see in this material world. Okay. So question for you. What is the origin of this universe? Big bang, big band, intelligent design, or by chance? Huh? Yes. What is the origin of this universe? Intelligent design, yes. Anyone else? The better level.
Just watch. थोड़ा पास में देखो
ऑन हो गए ऑन है यस सो इट इज इंटेलिजेंट डिजाइन नॉट बिग बैंग और बिग बैंड और चांस ओके व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्स ईट स्लीप बी मैरी कभी खुशी कभी गम नो पर्पस और टू अंडरस्टैंड गॉड एंड लाइफ यस सो वी आर कन्विंस्ड देयर इज सम पर्पस बिहाइंड दिस यूनिवर्स इट इज नॉट ओनली फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ ईटिंग स्लीपिंग एंड एंजॉयिंग इट हैज अ मच हायर मच डीपर पर्पस व्हिच वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड ह्यूमन लाइफ इज मेंट to discover that purpose. Okay? Like we have a national government in which we have Home Ministry to implement law and order. We have Health Ministry to supply medicines. We have Energy, Ministry of Energy to supply electricity, lighting, Finance Ministry to supply currency or wealth, Defense Ministry to protect us from dangers, Education Ministry. Similarly, there is a universal government in which also there are laws. If you violate those laws, If you violate those laws, there are consequences. If one smokes, cancer is a consequence. If one intoxicates, liver problem is a consequence. So like this, for every violation of the law, there is a consequence in this universal government. Like state government provides different medicines, even this nature, this universal world supplies various Ayurvedic herbs. There are sun and moon to provide energy. There are gold, silver, Navratnas, you know, in terms of what do you call the wealth. Okay, in terms of protection, you have ozone sphere, you have immunity in the body, which protects us from external infections, isn't it? Similarly, in terms of education, there are various bona fide scriptures like Vedas, Bible, Quran. So there is a parallel universal government working, which we need to study and understand. Understand what are its laws so that we understand, follow them. Yeah. Not knowing the law is not an excuse. Isn't it? If you cross a red light and then go and tell the police inspector, I am not aware of this law. Will you be excused? No. You'll be punished for two reasons. One, because of not being aware, and second, violation. Okay. So nothing is happening without intervention of a very organized body or person who is controlling all these aspects of this universe. Behind every government, there is a prime minister. Similarly, behind the universal government, there is a God. Okay? Prime minister maintains and controls the country. God maintains and controls this whole universe. Government law abiders live happily. Government law breakers are punished. Similarly, God's law abiders live purposefully, peacefully, and law breakers are punished. As simple as that. Very simple analogy. But we're not aware which is his government. Who are the cabinet ministers? What are they controlling? What are the laws? If you violate, what are the punishments? In Gita, Krishna says, very important verse. Mattaha parataram nanyat kinchit asti dhananjaya mai sarvam idam protam sutramani ganeya. O Arjuna, everything rests upon me as pearls are strung on a necklace. You see a necklace of pearls, you can see only pearls. You can't see the string which hold all the pearls together. Can you see? Similarly, there's someone which is holding everything together, but not visible. So we see different pearls visible to us. We saw so many pearls like this. Sun, moon, they're all pearls, but they are strung on a thread which is not visible to us. So, according to scriptures, God is defined as one who is the cause of all causes. Sab karano ke karan. But he does not have any cause. He is the supreme cause of everything which happens in this universe. He is the final cause. Like I have a father. He is my cause, right? He has his father. He is the cause of my father. If you go till end, that person who does not have any cause is called God. No further cause. He doesn't have any father. So he's the cause of all causes. Second, he is the supreme controller. Nothing happens without his sanction. Not even a blade of grass moves without the sanction of this personality called as God. Third, supreme proprietor. He is the owner of everything, not you and me. See, when we say this apartment belongs to whom, we say it belongs to me. For example, I'm talking apartment and then I produce some paper. What that paper is? What document? Patta or registration. How many names change in that patta? So who is the proprietor? He is the proprietor. Okay. We will discuss in detail in subsequent sessions. And finally, the supreme enjoyer. Okay. Now the question is, we all agree that somebody exists, but how do we know who is that person? The next question is, who is a person? As we mentioned, it is not left to individual perception. It has to be very objective. Who is that person? And that is a session we'll talk about in the next third session. How do we get access to this truth to find out, to discover who is that person whom we call as God or the Supreme Personality of Godhead? So in summary, in today's discussion, the various observations, to various views of different scientists, right? We were convinced that there's somebody, some supreme power behind everything. But the next question is, who is that supreme power? How do we objectively find out? How do we get access to this truth? That is the subject matter of next session. Okay, thank you very much. Now it's open for questions. Yes, you can raise your hand and then ask questions. Anyone? A lot of videos are off. I hope you all are hearing what to discuss. Yes, Dr. Deepan.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, I just want to ask, आपने सर लॉ ऑफ कर्मा बताया कि हाँ कि आपको कर्म करना है ऐसे करना है ठीक है. एक चीज मुझे एक जगह मैंने पढ़ा था कि दैट इफ यू आर बॉर्न पुअर इट्स नॉट योर फॉल्ट बट इफ यू डाई पुअर इट्स योर फॉल्ट.
सो एज आई मेंशन व्हाट इज लॉ ऑफ कर्मा यू शुड फाइंड आउट फ्रॉम द राइट सोर्स.
ओके
सो is not somebody's opinion which matters. Okay. The question is from Dr. Deepan. He said he has heard it is written it is not a problem that you are born poor. It is a problem if you die poor. It means you should work hard and remove your poverty, isn't it?
यस सर. एक होता है कि मेरी किस्मत में लिखा है, लेकिन किस्मत में लिखा है तो उसके लिए कर्म करना पड़ेगा ना उस चीज के लिए. कोई चीज अगर भगवान ने लिखी है कि हाँ चलो ये लिखा है आपकी किस्मत में. हम कुंडली दिखाते हैं, हाथ दिखाते हैं, ये भी करते हैं वो भी करते हैं, ये हमारी बिलीफ है कि हाँ एक ये पावर है जो ये चीज हमारी ठीक करेगी. ठीक है, लेकिन उसके लिए हमें कर्म वो तो खुद करना है वो तो. तो ये जो कोरिलेशन है इसको कैसे मतलब किया, मतलब
जो हमारे जीवन में घटित होता है उसको बोलते हैं प्रारब्ध. क्या बोलते हैं
जी?
क्या बोलते हैं? प्रारब्ध.
प्रारंभ.
प्रारब्ध.
हाँ ओके.
इसका मतलब ये है कि हमारे पिछले कई लाइफ टाइम्स के कई यू नो जीवन काल के कर्म संचित हैं, इकट्ठे हो चुके हैं. ठीक है, हमें पता नहीं, उसको हम काउंट नहीं कर सकते. इट इज अनलिमिटेड लाइफ टाइम वी हैव एंड वी कैरी रिएक्शंस ऑफ दोस कर्मास. वो कब मैच्योर होगा पता नहीं. ठीक है, उनमें से जो मैच्योर होने वाले हैं, ठीक है, वो मैच्योरिटी के हिसाब से हमको वो शरीर मिलता है, उनको भुगतने
जी. ओके,
ये जो शरीर मुझे मिला है मदन गोविंद दास को, ये मेरे प्रारब्ध के कारण मिला है. इस जीवन में जो भी अच्छा बुरा होना है उसको एक्सपीरियंस करने के मिला है. भौतिक रूप से ज्यादा मेहनत करके हम उसको बदल नहीं सकते
जी.
अभी जो करेंगे उसका असर हो सकता है अभी नजर आए या अगले जन्म में नजर आए, पर वो लॉ ऑफ कर्म के हिसाब से उसकी चर्चा हम करेंगे. कि भगवद गीता में तीन तरह के कर्म का वर्णन किया गया है
जी सर.
एक बोलते हैं कर्मा, एक बोलते हैं विकर्मा, एक बोलते हैं अकर्मा. पहला
कर्मा, विकर्मा, अकर्मा.
अब ये लॉज के अनुसार है. जैसे
जी
ट्रैफिक लाइट का पालन करना
जी,
ये लॉज के अनुसार
जी अकॉर्डिंग टू लॉ
ये कर्म है. लेकिन ये लेफ्ट ट्रैफिक लाइट क्रॉस कर देंगे ये विकर्मा है. ठीक है, हमने लॉ को अवॉइड नहीं किया, वायलेट किया. तो वैसे ही नेचुरल देयर लॉज ऑफ दिस कॉस्मिक नेचर, इफ यू एक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू दोज लॉज दे आर कॉल्ड कर्मास. इफ यू वर्क अगेंस्ट दोज लॉज दे आर कॉल्ड कर्म. इज समथिंग स्पेशल विच आई विल नॉट डिस्क्लोज नाउ, आई विल टॉक अबाउट इन द कोर्स ऑफ इट सेशन. टू आंसर योर क्वेश्चन, आवर डेस्टिनी इज फिक्स्ड. ठीक है, यदि हमारे भाग्य में बहुत पैसा लिखा है तो मिलेगा, ऐसा नहीं लिखा है तो नहीं मिलेगा. क्या इसका अर्थ है कि मेहनत नहीं करनी चाहिए? नहीं, मेहनत हमको पूरी करनी चाहिए.
Give उस दिशा में तो काम करना चाहिए.
Give your best and leave the rest. This is the principle. Do your best and क्योंकि आप आपके कर्म का कौन सा फल आपके सामने आ रहा है आप कोरिलेट नहीं कर पाए। आईआईटी के लिए एडमिशन के लिए लाखों बच्चे अपीयर होते हैं, करेक्ट, कोटा ऐसे स्टूडेंट से भरा पड़ा है
जी।
कितने बच्चों को एडमिशन मिलता है, मेहनत सब करते
हैं जी।
ऐसा नहीं है कि जो ज्यादा मेहनत करता है उसको मिलता है, नहीं, मेहनत सब करते हैं, बराबर करते हैं, लेकिन कुछ ही बच्चों को मिलता है एडमिशन। क्यों? उनके प्रारब्ध के कारण। लेकिन जैसे मैंने पहले भी बताया था, इस प्रारब्ध को हम बदल सकते हैं केवल आध्यात्मिक इंटरवेंशन के द्वारा। ओनली थ्रू स्पिरिचुअल इंटरवेंशन डेस्टिनी कैन बी मॉडिफाइड, कैन बी चेंज, ओके, नॉट थ्रू
फिजिकल
मटेरियल हार्डवर्क।
ठीक है,
ठीक है,
थैंक यू,
थैंक यू,
ठीक है, थैंक यू, थैंक यू।
Yes, anyone else? Sumer ji, yes.
Sir, good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, जो दीपन जी ने जो क्वेश्चन पूछा था, जिसका जवाब आपने दिया कि प्रारब्ध कर्म और संचित, मतलब प्रारब्ध कर्म होता है, लेकिन ये सब हमारा बेस्ड है कि पुनर्जन्म अगर हम मानते हैं तो ही। कई धर्म है जो कि पुनर्जन्म को नहीं मानते हैं, उसमें इसकी व्याख्या कैसे की जाएगी?
ठीक, बड़ा अच्छा प्रश्न है आपका। देखिए, किसी के मानने या मानने ना मानने से तथ्य बदलता नहीं है, है ना? फैक्ट इज ए फैक्ट वेदर आई एग्री और आई डोंट एग्री। ठीक है, अभी हमने देखा कि there is some supreme power, some god which exists, ठीक है? अब कोई कहेगा मेरे हिसाब से तो नहीं, तो क्या उनके ना मानने से गॉड विल नॉट एग्जिस्ट, विल सीज टू एग्जिस्ट जस्ट बिकॉज आई डोंट एग्री, है ना? तो पुनर्जन्म और reincarnation इज अ रियलिटी, इट इज नॉट somebody's ओपिनियन। यदि पुनर्जन्म नहीं होता तो हमारे इस भौतिक संसार में इतनी विविधता नहीं होती, इतनी डाइवर्सिटी नहीं होती, है ना? हम कैसे एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हैं कोई इतने अमीर खानदान में पैदा होता है, कोई इतने गरीब खाने पैदा होता है, कोई बहुत सुंदर पैदा होता है, कोई बहुत बदसूरत होता है, क्या आधार है उसका? उसका आधार है पिछले जन्म के कर्म, यानी कि पुनर्जन्म इज ए रियलिटी। इसको माने या ना माने उससे ये तथ्य बदलने वाला नहीं है, है ना? इवन साइंटिस्ट, मेनी साइंटिस्ट हैव प्रूव्ड साइंटिफिकली दैट रीइंकार्नेशन इज ए रियलिटी। एक बैंगलोर में साइंटिस्ट से मैं नाम बताऊंगा जब हम चर्चा करेंगे हु एम आई, उसमें रीइंकार्नेशन की चर्चा होने वाली है, है ना? जब हम हमारा असली अस्तित्व क्या है इसके बारे में चर्चा करेंगे, देन रीइंकार्नेशन इज आल्सो इज वन ऑफ द डिस्कशन पॉइंट्स। गीता में भगवान कहते हैं, क्या कहते हैं, देहिनो अस्मिन यथा देहे कोमारम यौवनम जरा तथा देहांतर प्राप्ति। देहांत के बाद कुछ प्राप्त होने वाला है, एक और शरीर मिलने वाला है, ठीक है? तो जब ऐसे बोनेफाइड प्रमाणिक स्क्रिप्चर में बोल दिया, और हम अपने अनुभव से भी देख पाते हैं कि देयर इज सम प्रिंसिपल बिहाइंड सो मच ऑफ डाइवर्सिटी इन दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड, देन वेदर वन एग्रीज और ही डज नॉट एग्री, इट डजंट मैटर, है ना? तो लोगों का व्यक्तिगत मत महत्वपूर्ण नहीं है, हमारे शास्त्र क्या बोलते हैं, हम अनुभव क्या कर रहे हैं, वो महत्वपूर्ण है, है ना? Did I answer आपके प्रश्न का उत्तर मिला कि नहीं सुमेर जी?
जी सर।
ओके, थैंक यू वेरी
मच, थैंक यू सर।
आप कोई बोले मैंने हवा को देखा नहीं है, मैं तो मानता नहीं हवा नहीं, अब उस मानने ना मानने से क्या होता है ना? Somebody say, I have not seen America. तो मेरे हिसाब से अमेरिका एग्जिस्ट नहीं करता है, है ना। तो व्यक्तिगत मत महत्वपूर्ण नहीं है इसमें, है हमारे प्रमाणिक स्रोत क्या बोलते हैं, हमारा अनुभव क्या है, वो महत्वपूर्ण है। और कोई किसी का प्रश्न है, कोई भी शंका आप पूछिए, हैं कोई मन में शंका लेके मत जाइएगा। यस शंकर जी बोलिए।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून
सर। एक्चुअली आई वाज टेकिंग द लेसंस अ कपल ऑफ मंथ्स बैक फॉर अ स्टूडेंट एंड आई टॉक्ड अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द यूनिवर्स। There I talked about the Big Bang theory. So the student was agree with the whatever I have explained in the class. But when I said there was a question by the student, student says, "Okay, I agree with the Big Bang, but who came to bang the matter?" So I wasn't having any answer for that.
So there are different ways to acquire knowledge. One of them is called as anuman praman, making judgment. So this Big Bang theory is judgmental; it has no sound basis. That's why this theory is actually banned in many universities. It is not being discussed anymore. It is a matter of misfortune that we are teaching such wrong theories in our curriculum. They should be taught how universe is created from Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam talks about how entire universe is created. What came first, then came what, then came what, then came what, then Panch Mahabhuta, then Panch Gyanendriya, then Panch Karmendriya. This entire process of creation is very scientifically explained in our scriptures. But I am not sure why are we discussing such theories which are based on speculation, simple judgment, not based on some scientific or, you know, some bona fide, you know, preferences. So Big Bang theory has no meaning. So I'll read what Big Bang theory says, then you'll also understand it has no meaning. Just give me one sec. I didn't spend much time on that because it was not worth spending.
Sir, hello.
Just one second. Okay. So, Big Bang theory says, according to the Big Bang theory, everything began from a point of infinite temperature, infinite density, infinitesimal size that is physically indescribable, mathematically unverifiable, beyond all conceptions of space and time. It is like I don't know anything. It's like saying I have no idea about how this universe got created.
Actually, according to this concept, we talk about that everything was concentrated at very small size at one point, suddenly it bang. And the universe created.
So you mean even living entities can be generated from matter, correct? It means even living entities can be generated from matter. Can we produce one living entity in our laboratory? Even one mosquito, even one mosquito. Forget about human being. We can't.
That is not possible.
Life comes from life. Life does not come from matter.
Yes.
So this Big Bang is, you know, big fraud. So we should not teach this in our schools and colleges.
Thank you, sir.
एक ले लूँ यहाँ पर उसके बाद. हाँ प्रीति जी, yes. Thank you. और कोई प्रश्न आपका?
शंकर. No, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, प्रीति.
अभी चर्चा चली थी आईआईटी में एडमिशन्स के लिए there are so many students.
एक हाँ जी.
आपने कहा कि only through spiritual intervention our destiny can be improved.
Yes.
So what we have to do to walk on that spiritual path?
So in fourth and fifth session talk about it. What is practical spirituality which we all can execute very easily? and change our destiny for good. Before we discuss that, we need to discuss about our real identity, which is subject matter of next session. Once we have that clarity, then we can appreciate this answer. Otherwise, we'll not be able to understand. Two sessions, you have to enjoy it. How we can change destiny through spiritual interventions, spiritual activities.
Thank you.
Hanji, ek prashn yahan par hai.
तो अब वो जब इतना मेहनत कर रहे हैं कि मेरा हो जाए हो जाए हो जाए आईआईटी में एडमिशन somehow I can get admitted, लेकिन वो इच्छा भी यही रख रहा है कि मेरा एडमिशन हो जाए, ठीक है ना सर? तो फिर यहाँ क्यों कहा गया है कि फल की इच्छा न रखे? फल के लिए सभी
क्या फल
वर्किंग फॉर सम ऑफ द अदर कॉज सम ऑफ द अदर फ्रूटफुलनेस कि भाई ये करने से ये मिल जाएगा, ये जैसे ये कोर्स अटेंड किया तो वी आर इन सर्च ऑफ हैप्पीनेस कि भाई ये कोर्स अटेंड करेंगे तो वी में अटेंड सम हैप्पीनेस सम सेल्फ डिस्कवरी सम नहीं. तो दिस इज ए रीजन कि अल्टीमेट रिजल्ट आफ्टर 5 सेशन दिस विल बी कमिंग आउट ऑफ इट. सो ये फल की इच्छा ही है कि वी आर ऑल हियर.
यस, दिस इज नहीं, अच्छा प्रश्न है. तो इसका उत्तर मुझे अभी थोड़ा स्पिरिचुअली देना पड़ेगा. हम अभी चर्चा कर रहे थे, दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड गिव्स अस लॉट ऑफ मिजरीज, है ना, बर्थ डेथ ओल्ड एज डिसीज, है ना? क्यों मिलता है? हाँ, लेकिन क्यों? क्योंकि हमारी कर्म के फल में आ सकती है. एक होता है कर्म बंधन, जो जीव को इस भौतिक जगत में बांध के रखता है, निकलने नहीं देता यहां से, है ना. जब कहा जाता है कि बिना अनासक्ति के करो, कर्म करने को मना नहीं कर रहे हैं, कहीं पर मना नहीं किया कि आप कर्म मत करो. क्या बोला है? कर्म के फल में आसक्ति मत रखो, क्योंकि आसक्ति पे पहला तो हमारा उसके फल के ऊपर हमारा नियंत्रण नहीं है, है क्या? है ना, तो केवल आसक्ति से वो फल मिलने वाला
नहीं
है. दूसरा, वो फल में आसक्ति जीव को इस भौतिक जगत के कर्म बंधन में बांध के रखती है, यहां से निकलने नहीं देती. भगवद गीता के तीसरे अध्याय में बताया गया कर्मयोग के बारे में. क्यों बिना फल में आ सकते? भगवान ने चार चीजें कही, कर्मण्येवाधि कारस्ते मा फलेषु कदाचना. उसके बाद दो चीजें और कही हैं, वो हम चर्चा नहीं करते, है ना. पहला कहा कर्म को अधिकार समझ के करो, लेकिन कर्म के फल में आसक्ति मत रखो. क्यों? क्योंकि उसके फल में आपका नियंत्रण नहीं है. पर इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि आप कर्म मत करो. चौथी बात ये भी कही है. तो जब हम लॉ ऑफ कर्म चर्चा करेंगे, तब चर्चा करेंगे कि क्यों बिना फल में आसक्ति के कर्म करना आवश्यक. कर्म तो करना ही है, खाली बैठ नहीं सकते हम लोग, लेकिन बिना फल में आसक्ति, ठीक है. तो लॉ ऑफ कर्म में चर्चा करेंगे इसकी, क्यों ऐसा कहा जाता है. बड़ा अच्छा प्रश्न है ये. तो ये मोटिवेशन चाहिए ना कुछ. हमारा मोटिवेशन क्या है? एडमिशन चाहिए, ही मोटिवेशन है. लेकिन इससे बड़ा एक और मोटिवेशन है, और वो क्या है? वो जब तक स्पिरिचुअल नॉलेज नहीं मिलती, उस मोटिवेशन का ज्ञान नहीं मिलता है. जब हमको बड़ा मोटिवेशन मिलेगा, ये छोटा मोटिवेशन, हाँ ठीक है. When you have higher purpose in life, lower purposes do not mean much. Yes. यहां पर किसी का प्रश्न है? काबरा जी आप बहुत ध्यान सुन रहे थे, हैं वेरी नाइस टू सी, वेरी अटेंटिव हियरिंग, हैं कोई जिज्ञासा है आपकी?
नहीं जी, बहुत अच्छे बता रहे हैं एकदम, कोई जिज्ञासा नहीं है, क्वेश्चन आंसर हो रहे हैं, सब सुन रहे हैं।
ठीक है। यस हुमा जी बताइए प्लीज।
हरे कृष्णा प्रभु जी।
हरे कृष्णा।
ये भगवान हमसे क्यों कराना चाहते हैं, वो तो सब कर सकते हैं, तो खुद क्यों नहीं सबको वो कर लेते, ठीक कर लेते?
हाँ ये भी अच्छा प्रश्न है, क्या जरूरत है, सब कुछ तो उनके कंट्रोल में है ना।
हाँ फिर हमसे क्यों कह रहे हैं?
हाँ हर जीव के पास एक अल्प स्वतंत्रता है। क्या है?
अल्प स्वतंत्रता, थोड़ा फ्रीडम है।
फ्रीडम है। भगवान उस जीव की स्वतंत्रता में दखल अंदाजी नहीं करना चाहते। भई हम रोबोट तो नहीं है ना, रिमोट चलाएं, हमारे अंदर इमोशंस हैं, है कि नहीं है? प्रेम है, इमोशंस हैं, सेंटीमेंट्स हैं। वी आर नॉट लाइक ए रोबोट यू ड्राइव थ्रू सम रिमोट कंट्रोल, कहो बैठ जाओ तो बैठ जाओ, बोलो खड़े हो तो खड़े हो जाओ, बोलो चलो चलो, ऐसा नहीं है हमारे साथ ना।
मतलब भगवान चाहते हैं कि हम उनकी मर्जी से उनका कहना, अपनी मर्जी से उनका कहना माने।
हम जैसे आपका बेटा है मान लो, आप बेटे को कितना फोर्स कर सकते हो? आप कह सकते हो उसके कंधे बंदूक रख के भी प्रणाम करो मेरे को, तो कैसा लगेगा आपको? प्रणाम कर भी देगा आपको,
क्या फायदा
नहीं आएगा, है ना? लेकिन वो अपनी इच्छा से आपके चरण स्पर्श करेगा तो आपको ज्यादा आनंद आएगा। तो भगवान चाहते हैं कि हम विलिंगली है ना उनका स्मरण करें, फोर्सफुली नहीं। यू कैन नॉट लव एनी वन फोर्सफुली, यू कैन लव एनी वन वॉलेंटरली, है ना? तो भगवान चाहते हैं हम वॉलेंटरली सरेंडर करें, फोर्सफुली नहीं, बंदूक दिखाकर नहीं, है ना? तो हमको जीवन मतलब उस अल्प स्वतंत्र का उपयोग, सदुपयोग, दुरुपयोग नहीं। प्रॉब्लम यह है कि हम उस स्वतंत्र का क्या कर रहे हैं,
अपनी मर्जी से जब जब अच्छा लगता है तो अच्छा कर लेते हैं, कभी कभी बुरा कर लेते हैं,
दुरुपयोग कर रहे हैं। जैसे एक छोटे बच्चे को दी जाती है स्वतंत्रता, उसको मोबाइल दिया जाता है, फ्रीडम गिवन टू द चाइल्ड बाई गिविंग ए मोबाइल। अब वो सदुपयोग कर सकता है, उसका दुरुपयोग भी कर सकता है, है ना? तो प्रॉब्लम क्या है, ज्यादातर जीव उस स्वतंत्रता का दुरुपयोग करते हैं। इसलिए गीता, भागवतम, वेद, शास्त्र ये सब बनाए गए हैं हम बताने के लिए कि हम उस फ्रीडम का इस्तेमाल पर्पजफुली कैसे करें।
उसके बाद क्या होगा जब सरेंडर कर दिया भगवान को, सब प्यार करते हैं, तो उसके बाद क्या,
उसके बाद
अल्टीमेटली क्या होना है?
हाँ उसके बाद क्या होना है, जैसे उदयपुर में एक जेल है, ठीक है, हमारे बस स्टैंड के पास में, उस जेल में कौन जाते हैं?
जिसको पनिशमेंट मिला, जिसने कुछ गलत किया। हाँ,
और जब वो सुधर जाता है तो क्या होता है?
वापस।
वापस कहाँ?
बाहर, जेल के बाहर।
हाँ तो ऐसे ही ये भौतिक जगत इज लाइक ए प्रिजन हाउस, जिसमें हमको ये जन्म मृत्यु जरा व्याधि जैसी समस्याएं का सामना करना पड़ता है। इफ यू इंप्रूव सरेंडर, हमारा जो क्या बोलते हैं बिहेवियर ठीक हो जाए अकॉर्डिंग टू द लॉज ऑफ नेचर, फिर हम भी वापस जा सकते हैं, यहां से बाहर निकल सकते।
यहाँ से बाहर कहाँ?
तो जैसे जेल के बाहर एक और जगत है, वैसे ही भौतिक जगत के बाहर एक और जगत है जिसको अध्यात्मिक जगत बोलते हैं, जिसको वैकुंठ बोलते हैं। देखिए उसको वैकुंठ क्यों बोलते हैं, कुंठ का मतलब होता है दुख दर्द, और वैकुंठ का मतलब क्या हुआ, जहां कोई दुख दर्द नहीं है। तो ये भौतिक जगत को बोलते हैं कुंठ, उसको बोलते हैं वैकुंठ, प्लेस वेयर देयर इज नो मिजरी। This material world is called as dukhalayam, a place of misery. Nobody can escape. मुझे बताइए आप में से एक भी ऐसा व्यक्ति है जो कहे वो आज तक बीमार नहीं हुआ है? कोई भी ऐसा है? कोई भी ऐसा जो कह सकता है मैं कभी बूढ़ा नहीं होऊंगा? कोई भी ऐसा व्यक्ति है? कोई भी कह सकता कि नहीं मृत्यु नहीं होगी, कोई नहीं कह सकता है. Everybody has to, by exception, without exception, face these problems. But there is a place where such problems do not exist, which is outside the prison house. Okay. So the goal of life is not to settle down in prison house comfortably. Goal of life is to get out of the prison house. Problem ye hai, everybody is planning to stay here comfortably. That is not the problem.
Hamari natural state kya hai? Aapne last session mein bola tha, baad mein
bola. Is jigyasa ko aur teevra kijiye. Pata lagega. Jab tak hum apna संवैधानिक अस्तित्व को नहीं जानेंगे, जो हमारे फोर्थ सेशन का विषय है, तब तक समझ नहीं आएगा, है ना? तो मुझे आपका प्रश्न याद है, आप चिंता मत कीजिए. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू.
ओके, और कोई प्रश्न? मिस्टर महाजन, नो क्वेश्चन टुडे. अनम्यूट करके बोलिए. Yes.
I'm on a voice rest today.
Oh, so yes. You told me.
So I put a question in the chat box.
Yes, one sec. Lina, can you see his question? I can't see. Okay, you can search, Leena ji. In the meantime, I'll take some other questions. Or if you can type once again, if possible, Mr. Mahajan, thank you. Okay, anyone else? Are you finding these sessions meaningful? Any other question? I'm just waiting for the question. Just hold on, please. Shankar, do you also have a question? You raise your hand? No, okay. What is dharma? Does it change with time and situation? Okay, very nice question. क्वेश्चन है कि धर्म क्या है, डज इट चेंज विद टाइम एंड सिचुएशन. देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ धर्मस, वन इज कॉल्ड नैमितिक एंड सेकंड इज कॉल्ड नित्य. वन इज बेस्ड ऑन बॉडी, वन इज बेस्ड ऑन सोल. हालांकि अभी तक आत्मा का विषय चर्चा नहीं किए, बट स्टिल आई विल ट्राई आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. One is based on body. Today I am male, husband. So I have pati dharma to perform. Correct? Next life, I become female, for example. I become wife. So my dharma will change. So dharma can change based on one's body. This is called naimittik dharma. Okay. Today, for example, in this life, I am Brahmana. Next life become Kshatriya. My dharma will change. Brahmanas have different dharma, Kshatriya different dharma. Brahman ka dharma kya hota hai? Patan patan, padhna padhana. Kshatriya ka dharma kya hota hai? Raksha karna. administration. Dharma will change. But there is one dharma which never changes. It is called as Nitya Dharma. Dharma of soul. Why? Soul never changes. So dharma never changes. Like sweetness cannot be separated from sugar. Eternal dharma or nitya dharma cannot be separated from the soul. Or what dharma kya hai, wo hum charcha karenge. Theek hai? So external body based dharma changes, but the dharma of soul never changes in any life, which is very important. The question from Mr. Mahajan is, we all know that God exists, as very well explained by you. Why the mankind has created so many religions and many gods, which have created so many problems globally? Very wonderful question. So while this will be answered in next session, I'll still briefly touch upon the subject. Okay. Why so many religions? If God is one. Or God also are many. America has different God, India has different God. No, God is one. Like sun is one for America and, you know, Hindustan. Similarly, God is also one. Then why so many religions? For example, a small child comes to you, Mr. Mahajan. I'm asking you a question. And suppose you're a doctor. Dr. Mahajan. He comes to you and asks, "Uncle, uncle, please tell me, when we eat food, what happens inside the belly?" What will he answer? Any layman answer will do. What will you say? Acha, aap bol nahi payenge. Sorry, I'm sorry. Let me ask somebody else. Akant Prabhu, please unmute yourself. Let me illustrate this answer. Suppose somebody comes to you, small child comes to you and asks you, "What happens if I eat food in my stomach?" What will you answer?
It gets digested in the stomach, and then the nutrients get absorbed inside the body.
And the stuff which is not required comes out.
Correct?
So this is what happens at. Now suppose a medical student approaches his professor and asks this question, "What happens when we eat?" Will you give the answer in the same manner, or answer could be very different?
It will be much more in depth and
you give answer based on capacity to understand of the audience, correct?
Correct.
Based on one's understanding, you will give answer. So different people have different capacity to digest, different capacity to understand. That's why different religions with different degree of explanation manifest at different point in time. Principles of all such religions is same. Details are different. Right? What is different? Details. But the principle is?
God exists.
Same. That's why different religions. But problem is, it's not that because of different religions, people fight. People fight because they don't understand what the religion is. Fight is not because of different religions. Fight is because they don't understand the principles. That's why they fight on details. Samajh rahe na? Ek hota hai principle, ek hota hai detail. Which is more important? Principle is more important. For example, Gandhi ji said, "You should wear khadi." Correct? Kya tha? You should wear khadi. What is the principle behind this? We become self-dependent. Correct? Yes or no?
Yes.
principle is this. Detail is khadi. As somebody says, I follow Gandhi ji because I wear khadi, which is imported from China. Is he following detail or principle?
Detail.
Ah, he has not understood principle. And somebody says, I am a medical representative. I have to go to different doctors. I wear this pant shirt, which is made in India. Now tell me, who is following Gandhiji?
Second.
Why? He is following the principle.
Principle.
These are very details. People fight because of different details.
Not the principle.
They have not understood the principle. That's very different. Okay. If they have understood, if they follow their own reason perfectly, they will make advancement. Probably they don't follow. They don't even understand. Forget about following. So you need to understand what the principle. Principle can unite everyone. Details can disunite everyone. Does that answer your question, Mr. Mahajan? Okay. Okay, any other question? Shweta Mineria ji. Yes.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. Yes.
My question is that, as you told, Karmanya Vadika Raste Ma Faleshu Kadachan Ma Karm Fal Hetu Gurma Te Sango Asatva Karmani. So, हमारी कर्म में फल में आसक्ति भी नहीं होनी चाहिए, कर्म में ही अधिकार है. तो इन दिस मटेरियलिस्टिक वर्ल्ड हाउ कैन वी कीप बैलेंस इन आवर माइंड कि हाँ फल की इच्छा भी नहीं करनी है और कर्म भी करना है. तो कर्म करने में जो एनकरेजमेंट है वो कैसे मिलेगा?
सो एनीथिंग वी डू आउट ऑफ सम मोटिवेशन. करेक्ट right na? Motivation is very important. That is the impetus for us to do anything.
Yeah, exactly.
Abhi, because we do not understand spiritual subject in detail, our motivation is only one, to earn and enjoy. Correct? That is the only motivation we have. That's why we perform karma. Correct?
Yeah.
But when we understand this subject in detail, we understand karma, vikarma, akarma, we understand bondage, we understand liberation, then our motivation will change. You know? When you have full understanding of subject, then motivation will change. And the motivation level changes, then these will happen, what Krishna is saying. Don't get attached to the result. Because there is a consequence of attachment to the result, which we do not know now. But when we know, we will understand why Krishna is saying this. है ना? जब हमें पता लगेगा ना इसका consequence क्या है? जैसे एक बच्चे को बोलो आग में हाथ नहीं डालना है, वो डालेगा. लेकिन जैसे डालेगा, जब उसे पता लगेगा कि आग में हाथ डालने से हाथ जल जाता है, फिर डालेगा?
नहीं.
Why? He knows the consequence of putting his hand to fire. Abhi, we don't know what is the consequence of attachment to the results. That's why that is our motivation. But when we know there is a serious consequence of attachment to the results, then our motivation will change. Okay, that's why the subject matter comes in the third chapter, not in the first chapter of Bhagavad Gita. So first understand two chapters, then you can understand this answer.
Thank you so much, sir.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. So, Mr. Mahajan, का एक प्रश्न है. Just one second. while you're not understanding the principles of legion is a cause of maximum death in the world, then how to reverse this? By making people understand principles of religion, as simple as that. They stop fighting. You know, when we make people understand what is the principle of religion, then he will not fight. That is the purpose of secessions. I mentioned last time also. We want people to understand what is spirituality, when it should be started, what does it entail, and practically. It is not a theoretical subject. It is something which is very practical. And when we increase the understanding of people about religion or spirituality, you know, all the problems will be solved, including this. All the problems. Not only this. All the problems of society will be solved. Any other question? Ashish, Prabhu, yes.
Yeah, Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
My question is that how will you deal in situations when someone other's karma or reactions affect your life?
Yes. Yes. So, for example, you have to take karmas of your wife and children also, to some extent. If they commit sinful activities, you also have to, you know, pay the consequences. So yes, there are, you know, some interconnections. That's why Bhagavad Gita teaches how to convert karma into akarma. What is akarma? Akarma doesn't mean not doing karma. Akarma means doing karma in such a way that there is no reaction. That is called karma koshalam, art of doing karma. Okay, so there is a method prescribed in Bhagavad Gita how to isolate oneself from such karmic reactions which arise from others. For example, you go and eat in a restaurant, correct? You're eating a food cooked by somebody who has certain degree of consciousness. His consciousness while cooking food will deliver some karmic reaction to you also who is eating it. You know this? So there is a method to protect oneself from such, you know, situations wherein we have to face consequences of others' karmas. How do that? Please have some more patience. Fourth and fifth session. When we talk about how to convert karma into akarma. Akarma means do the same thing, but the different consciousness, and one is protected from the result, from the consequence. That's why these subject matters are absolutely related to our life. We cannot afford to ignore them. Every moment, this knowledge which we are, you know, trying to understand is relevant. It is not a matter of choice to read or not to read Bhagavad Gita. No, it is a matter of necessity that everyone should know what is Bhagavad Gita and what are the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. So I'm happy that some people have shown interest and they want to understand Bhagavad Gita in detail. Sparing time on their weekends, coming on Sunday and spending a couple of hours. Not everyone do it. So you, as I mentioned, you know, in the first chapter, you all are very fortunate getting access to this knowledge. Okay, Ashish. Maybe last one or two questions we can take and then close. Any last, maybe comment, if not question. Okay, theek hai. Acha, check chat. Yeah, what is the question? ठीक है, all it, we'll close it now. So third session we'll have next time. There might be a need. I'm just asking everyone. We may need one more session, maybe total 6 sessions. I'll see if I can still squeeze in 5 sessions only. If it extended by one more session, are you all okay? Huh? Just raise your hand if you're okay. Okay. I don't want to rush. It's a very important subject. So if required, we'll take one extra session to cover it, you know, properly. Thank you very much. See you next week. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.